Good morning, students. I am Professor Rajeshwari Sharma here, and I welcome you all to e-learning session of TS College of Commerce, Wardha. So today we are going to discuss the chapter Demand Analysis, which is our first chapter under the second unit. In last few lectures, we have dealt with the meaning and concept of demand, the definition of demand, and the various factors affecting the demand, which is also known as determinant of demand. In today's lecture, we are going to see the types of demand. So let's start. So first one is individual demand and market demand. See, when I talk about the individual demand, so individual demand is a demand for a particular product made by an individual at a particular price during a particular period of time, taking into account the various factors like his money income, taste and preferences, prices of other related goods, etc. So we will understand it with the help of an example. This Mr. X, who demands 50 liters of oil at 80 rupees per liter, 80 rupees per liter for 1 month. So it is the individual demand for oil for a month. But now when I talk about the market demand, so what is market demand? Market demand is the sum total of individual demand. Means when all the individuals in the market or all the consumers in a market demands a particular product at particular price during a specified period of time, so it's known as market demand. Therefore, I have told you that market demand is the sum total of individual demand. We will understand it with the help of an example. So as we have seen in individual demand, Mr. X is demanding 50 liters of oil at 80 rupees per liter in a month. Now in market there are many consumers like Mr. X, Mr. Y, Mr. Z, Mr. A and many more. So Mr. Y demands 40 liters of oil for a month at the same price. Mr. Z demands 30 liters of oil for 1 month at the same price, and Mr. A demands again 30 liters of oil for 1 month in the same price. So when we are going to add the demand of all these individuals in the market, so it will be the total demand of oil in the market for 1 month at the price of 80 rupees per liter. So total demand will be 50 plus 40, 90, 90 plus 30, 120, and it's 150 liter. So we will say total market demand for oil is 150 liter at 80 rupees per liter in 1 month. So I hope the concept of individual demand and market demand is clear to you now. Now we will move towards the demand for firm's product and the industry's product. So before understanding the demand for firm's product and industry's product, we need to understand what is firm and what is industry. So what is firm? Firm is an individual unit of industry. Firm is a small part of industry, and industry is a group of many firms. So we will understand it with the help of an example. If I talk about the Toyota cars, so what is Toyota cars? It's a firm in automobile industry. And when I talk about the Toyota cars, Maruti Suzuki, Bajaj Auto Limited, Tata Motors, TVS Motors Company, etc. So what is this? This is the sum total of all the firms in automobile industry. So now we will understand the demand for firm's product and the demand for industry's product. See, if I'm talking about the demand for a product of a particular firm in a market, so it's known as demand for firm product. If I For example, if I'm talking about the demand for Toyota cars in the market for a particular period of time, so it is a demand for firm's product. But if I talk about the demand for the cars of the various brands, like the demand for Toyota Motors, demand for the Bajaj Auto Limited, demand for the cars of Tata Motors, demand for the cars of TVS Motor Companies, etc. So when I talk about the demand for the cars of various brands, so it's known as the demand for the industry's product. Here it will be the demand for the product of the automobile industry. So this is the difference between the demand for the firm's product and the demand for the industry's product. Next one is autonomous demand and the derived demand. See, autonomous demand is a demand for those goods and services which are not associated on the demand of other products. This demand arises to fulfill certain personal needs of consumer. Like we demand food, we demand clothes, we demand shelter. So when we talk about the demand of all these things, so it is not the, these demands are not dependent on the demand of another commodities. This demand arises due to the survival needs. So demand for such goods and services and the products is known as the autonomous demand. Next one is derived demand. See, when we talk about the derived demand, so derived demand is a demand which arises due to the demand for another commodity. For example, demand for petrol, demand for diesel, demand for some raw material, etc. These are the products whose demand depends on the demand of another product. Like, the demand for petrol and diesel will increase if the demand for the vehicles will increase. The demand for the raw material will increase when the demand for the production of particular commodities for which that raw material is required will increase. So demand for all these products are dependent on the demand for another product. So such type of demand will be known as, or will be called as, derived demand. Next one is joint demand and composite demand. So joint demand are the demand for those products which are demanded jointly to satisfy a particular needs. The best example of joint demand is the demand for complementary goods like ink and paint, car and petrol, tea and sugar, etc. So when the two products are demanded together for satisfying a single want, so it's known as joint demand. Like without ink, you cannot use paint. Without petrol, you cannot use car. So demand for such product is known as joint demand. Next one is composite demand. So composite demand is the demand for those goods which can be used to put for several uses or multiple uses. So the example of such goods are electricity, coal, and if we talk about the factors of production like land, labor, capital, so these are also the factors which can be put to the several uses. So the demand for such factors or demand for such goods are known as composite demand. Like we will take an example, if I talk about the electricity, so electricity can be put to the household use, it can be put to the agricultural use, it can be put to the industrial use. So it is a single product which can be used for satisfying the multiple wants. So when the demand for such product arises, so it's known as the composite demand. The next one is direct and indirect demand. See, when I talk about the direct demand, so direct demand is the demand for those goods and services which are demanded for the final consumption, like food, clothes, etc. If I wear a cloth from the market, so it will directly be used for the it will be directly used by me for satisfying my own need. So it is a direct demand. And indirect demand, when we talk about the indirect demand, so indirect demand refers to demand for those products and services which are not ultimately used by the final consumer for the consumption purpose. It is used for the production of other goods and the services. Like if I talk about the demand of machineries. So machinery is not a product that is directly used by the consumer, but it is a product which is used by the producer for production of those goods and services which will be provided to the consumer. So when we talk about the direct demand, so direct demand is there for the consumer goods and services. And if I talk about the indirect demand, so indirect demand is there in the market for the producer's goods and the services. Next one is total market and market segment demand. See, when we talk about the market segment, so market is divided in different segment on the basis of different criteria, like on the basis of age, on the basis of sex, that is male and the female, on the basis of geographical region, etc. So that these are known as different market segments. So when I talk about the market segment demand, so when we consider the particular segment for measuring the demand, so it's known as the market segment demand. For example, if I take into consideration the demand for the Vadilal ice cream in Rajasthan, so it's going to be the market segment demand. But if I talk about the demand for Vadilal ice cream in all over the India, so it will be known as the total market demand. So total market demand is the sum total of all market segment demand. The next one is demand for the durable and the non-durable goods. So what is durable goods? Durable goods are those goods which can be used repeatedly, which can be used for the longer period of time, like furniture, clothes, etc. So durable goods are those goods which are not exhausted in single use. So the demand for such durable goods is known as the durable demand. And non-durable goods are perishable goods are those goods which are exhausted in single use, which cannot be repeatedly used by the consumer, like food items. If I buy the pizza from the Pizza Hut, so I can eat that pizza once, I can take the utility from that pizza only once. I cannot eat the same pizza again, right? If I want to eat the pizza, so I have to order again the another pizza. So the demand for those goods which are perishable or which can be utilized only once, or which is exhausted in single use, so demand for such product is known as the non-durable demand. So today we have discussed with the various types of demand. In tomorrow's lecture we will see the law of demand. Till then, stay safe, keep studying. Thank you.